أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد So we were continuing Surah Al-Baqarah Ayah number 186 وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ So we will see this in detail So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about you know Then my servants ask about me. So what when servants ask about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah will say here, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am very near. So Allah is very closer, but Allah is on arsh. But you know, the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very vast. So that's the thing here talking about. So when servants ask about me, say, I am very near. So, وَإِذَا and when سَأَلَكَ he asked عِبَادِي my slaves when my slaves ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so say I am very near to the like you know when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so what are the things we have to keep in mind like we should have complete yaqeen on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah will answer our prayers right And the thing is that we should ask only Allah, not any, you know, person. That is most important here. And Sa'alaka seen Hamza Lam. So you is the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When they ask Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ibadi, plural of Abd, my servants. Everyone is Abd of Allah. But when he says specifically my servants, So when it talks about my servants, here clearly talking about only, yani here talking about Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Always Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has been addressed like my slave. Means he has been given honor here. Try to understand that. So, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ وَإِذَا and when سَأَلَكَ he asked عِبَادِي my slaves أَنِّي my slaves فَإِنِّي so indeed I قَرِيبٌ near أُجِيبُ I respond دَعْوَةُ الدَّاعِ call the caller of the da'i so Allah will respond to the caller how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ الدَّعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ Whenever he call me. When we call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will respond. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding. So here, Allah is responding. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond, that is mentioned over here. So as I mentioned before, you should have complete yaqeen and tawakkul. That Allah will respond it. So how it respond and what are the things we have to take care of? Like you should have complete yaqeen and tawheed, like conviction on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here Sa'alaka seen Hamza Lam, you here is Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Here it is mentioning about Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that Allah is saying like when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked the plural of Ibadi is plural of Abd, my servants. Everyone is Abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when he says specifically my servant, that implies they are special servants. Okay? They are special servants. What it means here, special servants means talking about here special servants, specifically they are special servants who are his true servants. Who believe, worship him alone and obey him. So here it's like you know, believing and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is what we are talking about. And when we see that anni, about me, what does it mean when it says when my servants ask about me? So when Allah is saying when they ask about me, they are asking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so it means when my servant asks where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is his response that he is near some says that is regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qurb How near he is, some of the companions asked. Is he near? So we should talk to him in a whisper tone, or is he far? So should I speak loudly? This was asked about a Bedouin, a man. Once a group of Jews said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very high above, and there are seven heavens in between. So how can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hear you? Qareebun means he is close in his knowledge. Allah is close in his knowledge, his awareness. So here talking about his knowledge, his awareness, and in his hearing. So there is no need to shout. We can directly pray to him. He's closer to us than our jugular vein. It is mentioned in Quran. Does not mean in the physical sense, but rather in his knowledge. Hadith, we learn Imam Ahmad reported that Abu Musa al-Ashari said, we were in the company of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam during a battle. Whenever we would climb hill or go to a high place, we would say Allahu Akbar in a loud voice. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be merciful to yourself that you are not calling on someone who is absent or deaf. The one whom you call is closer to you than a jugular vein. So Allah's knowledge is so close in. But where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is? Allah is on Arsh. We have to keep that thing. His knowledge is vast. And Hadith Imam Ahmad said, I am as my servant thinks of me. I am with him whenever he invokes me. Ujib is from Jim Wauba, Jawab. I respond. Ad-da'i, any person who prays, calls to Allah, makes dua to him. Da'an, he calls me. When we make dua, we want our dua to be responded to the right away. We must call on him with the trust and confidence that he is the one who can respond to our request. There are several conditions that need to be fulfilled for the one's dua to be responded to. It should be made with the sincerity. It should be made with consciously, really meant it. One should be humble, small, tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you need him, and one should fear and respect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and person should be in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should not be committing any kind of sins. Hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says like that the supplication of the servant of the servants will be answered as long as he does not supplicate for what it includes sin. So one should not includes the sin. The thing is that you make dua against somebody, like you know, somebody like not getting anything and I am getting, there's nothing wrong asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but making such kind of dua like not to get anyone anything and you get that thing, that is incorrect. That is forbidden. So here we should keep in mind what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. We should ask. The dua should be proper and realistic. One should also not become hasty. Someone asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam how one can be hasty. He replied, when one says that they made dua again and again, they did not see their supplication being answered, and they abandoned making dua. You can't say like, you know, I'm making dua and my dua is not answered and they are getting hasty. That is forbidden here. One should not say that. You know, sometimes you make dua for years and years. What will happen? Allah answers. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is answering, we don't know. Allah knows best, right? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when Allah responds, we don't know how Allah is responding it, right? And for every little thing, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will respond to it. But how Allah respond and what are the prerequisite? We should ask only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no other person or thing. And make sure you should have complete conviction and yaqeen. But when we make dua and when we are shaky, that's not the way to make dua. You understand? One should have complete yaqeen when you are making dua. Then only your dua will be answered. So make sure that you make dua with the certainty and with the confidence that Allah will answer your dua. So that is the thing here mentioned. When Allah is there to answer you, and when you are making dua in such a kind of way, and you are not confident that Allah will answer, Allah will answer definitely. But how Allah will answer, you should have yaqeen on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how Allah will answer it. So sometimes it happens, it takes many years, right? But we don't know how our dua is answered, right? But you should have that certainty that Allah said, Allah will answer. When Allah says Allah will answer, definitely Allah will answer it, right? So you should have that yaqeen and certainty that Allah will answer the dua. And so make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exclusively, and make sure that you only ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no other person or thing, and you should have yaqeen on it. And make sure the vastness, that like, you know, when you make dua, it's like, you know, it's the you are having complete yaqeen on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah will answer for your dua, isn't it? But when person becomes, you know, if a person become despair, that is forbidden in Islam. One should not get despair, and that is the thing that is not appreciated in Islam. One should overcome with that, you know. Allah does not love person who get despair. And here we learn how is dua answered. Hadith, we learn no Muslim supplicates to Allah with dua that does not involve sin or cutting the relations of the womb that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him. One of the three things: Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hasten the response to his supplication, he will save it for him until the hereafter, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn an equivalent amount of evil away from him. So the people asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what if we continue to make dua? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have less. You can make as much dua as you want, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has more. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا, so they respond, answer, لِي for me, وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا, and they should believe, be in with me, لَعَلَّهُمْ, so that they يَرْشُدُونَ, they obtain guidance. So فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا جِيمْ وَاوْبَا, jawab is to respond. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is qareeb to us. He knows and respond to the caller when he makes dua. We should respond to the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to follow his command. It means that we should submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey him. Wal yu'minu, we should believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe that he is near and he respond to our call. We should refrain from disobeying him. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond to your dua, you must respond to him by obeying his commands. He must have this firm conviction, trust that he will answer our dua. He is Qadir, he is Aleem, he is just to say, kun fayakun. The more conviction we have, the more likely our dua will be answered. We should think positive of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yarshudun rashin dal. Rushd is guidance. It is to adopt the way of Hidayah and to stay firm upon it. Along with this, it is to develop and maintain good habit, as well as it is the istiqama or perseverance or Hidayah, and to be firm on its rushd is not just with the regard to matters of deen, it also with the regard to dunya. It also said rushd is to do something in the best manner. So here it means so that they live a good life, we should respond to him so that we are rightly guided. Dua is the essence of worship. A dua wal ibadah. It is said that when this ayah was revealed, people ask, is there a good time to make dua? It is a good to ask after doing an act of worship. The sahaba would even make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for us. So shoelace, when a person calls upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he responds, he's near, he knows. We should also respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should believe in him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trust him, and having conviction that he will respond, continuing to do what Iman requires and demands. One should not commit sins and expect their du'as to be accepted. So this is the ayah. It talks so much about the du'a, you know. So Allah says, "Wa iza saalaka ibadi anni fa inni qareeb." And when my servants ask you concerning me, that where is your Lord? He's near. Is he far? Tell them, indeed I am near. I respond to the invocation of the supplication when he calls upon me. There and then, meaning whenever you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning or the evening at home or wherever you are. Now there is no place like except, you know, in the washroom or the filthy places, better we don't take Allah's names, because there's the place we relieve ourselves. I'm talking about, so wherever you are, night or day, any place you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah responds. Allah says fal yastajibu li, so let them respond to me. Because remember, a relationship is two ways. So if you want to be heard, you better hear, you listen to other. Do not take anyone for granted. Don't just be taker, also be a giver. And remember that sins actually becomes a barrier between the servant and his Lord. So we want our du'as to be accepted, then we should also respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should accept Allah's command, and they should believe in me. So they should have hope, they should pray with the determination that they may be rightly guided. The fact is that we need to make dua as for our own benefits. We need guidance. So keep making dua in order that you may be guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout your life, no matter what you are going through. It is Ramadan or out of Ramadan, you know, just make dua, especially for those, you know, who are in need. Make dua. You can wake up in the tahajjud time, make dua. That's the best time, because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that three people whose dua is not rejected, one of them is wasiyamu hatta yuftira, the fasting person until he breaks his fast. Monday and Thursday you fast, or like ayyam bi, white days, 13, 14, 15, and 9th of Zilhajj, day of Arafah, you fast, your sins will be forgiven. That best time to make dua when you are fasting. So as long as you are fasting, making dua. Now some more rules related to fasting are given. So let's see the detail. It has been made permissible for you the night preceding fasting to go to your wife. So this was the, you know, when we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for dua, how the dua is answered. Ayah number 187 talks about uhilla lakum laylata siyam. We are doing Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 187. Those who want to join on Insta, they can join Insta, or they can join on the Facebook or YouTube. Uhilla, permitted, lakum, for you, laylata, the night, asiyama, fasting, rafasu, the approach, ila nisaikum, to your wives. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about when you approach to your wives. So what is the thing mentioned here? When you approach to your wife, so there are few more rules has been given what you have to do when you approach your wife. What are the things? Let's see. So when you approach to your wife, hunna libasu lakum wa antum libas. Hunna de libasu, garments, lakum, for you, wa antum, and libas, garment, lahunna, for them. Alimallahu, and Allah knows, annakum, that you kuntum, used to, takhtanuna, deceive, anfusakum, yourself. Fataba alaykum, so he turned towards you, wa'afa, he forgave, ankum, you, fal'ana, so now, bashiruhunna, have relation with them, wabtahu, and seek, ma kataba, what has ordained Allahu Allah, lakum, for you, kulu, and eat, washrabu, and drink, hatta, until yatabayyana, it make distinct lakum for you, al-khaytu, the thread, al-abyadu, the white, minal khayti, the thread, aswadi, the black. Minal fajr, the dawn. Summa atimu, then complete. Athiyamu, the fast. Ila layl, till the night. Wala tubashiruhunna, and have relation with them. Wa antum akifun, while you secluded. Here, you know, akifun, there are few more ruling regarding when you are do the etikaf. How the thing should be when you are doing the etikaf. Few more rules has been mentioned here when you are doing etikaf. Fil masjid, and where the etikaf should be, in the masjid. Fil masajid, so it will be from masjid. The plural of masjid is masajid. Tilka, these, hududallah, these are the limits of Allah. Fala taqrabuha, so do not approach them. Kazalika, thus yubayyinullahu, Allah makes it clear, ayatihi, his ayahs, verses, linnasi, for the people, la'allahum yattaqoon, so that they become righteous. So here in this ayah, it has been made permissible for you the night preceding fasting to go to your wives for sexual relations. They are clothing for you and you are clothing for them. Because, you know, before this hukum, there was not allowed husband and wife's relation in the night, even at the night time in the Ramadan. So Allah is clearing that. Now you can have it. You don't have to go without like feeling guilty and you should go or you shouldn't. But it is allowed now. So they are clothing to you and you are clothing for them. Clothing, what it does, it cover your body, it will adorn you, it will make you more beautiful. Sometimes clothing gets dirty, the same thing with the relationship. And it's like a covering, one has to hide. Sometimes husband may do mistake, wife may do. You are clothing to each other, you should hide each other, you should adorn each other. Allah knows that you used to deceive yourself. Means this was deceiving before this hukum came. They were deceiving. So he accepted your repentance and forgive you. So now have the relations with them and seek that which Allah has decreed to you. This is, you know, talking about the time when you get in the night. This is the time when you're not fasting, when you're not praying, you understand? That is the time which has been given for husband and wife to have relation, because that is also part of ibadah. So now have the relation with them, seek that which Allah has decreed for you. Eat and drink. What is the time you should eat and drink? Until what time? Until the white thread of dawn become distinct to you from the black thread of the night. Then complete the fast until the sunset. And do not have relation with them as long as you are staying for worship in the masjid. So this is, you know, not only talking about when you are fasting, you are not supposed to approach to your wife. Not only that, when you are in the itikaf, you are not supposed to do any such thing. Not only during the fasting and after fasting also, when you are in the itikaf, seclusion in the masjid, you are not supposed to approach to your wives. You are not supposed to have any chit chat or any kind of, you know, because you are there in the masjid to do the itikaf, and itikaf is done in the masjid, and it has been several hadith which proves that itikaf has to be done in the masjid, whether it's a male or female. These are the limits set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so do not approach them. Thus Allah makes clear his ordinance to the people that they may become righteous. So this is the list of things mentioned and how a person becomes righteous. So it has been made permissible for you the night preceding fasting to go to your wives, meaning for sexual relations. Because during the fast, this is not permissible, but during the night it is. Like after opening the fast, after the Isha, you know, after the Taraweeh. Like when you are not fasting, right? Like soon after you open your fast and yeah, you are good too. As far as you are not fasting, you are not in the state of fasting from the time of the fast start till the time you open your fast. You understand? They are clothing for you and you are clothing for them. And a person in need of their clothes, you know, remember that clothes covers a person, protects a person, beautify a person. So take care of this dress, the garment, this garment that Allah has given. Value it. Value this relationship. Give it attention that it deserves. And Allah knows that you used to deceive yourself. As I mentioned, you know, meaning before this hukum came, they were deceiving it. Okay. So here, meaning you are having relation in the night while you were initially unsure of its permissibility in the month of Ramadan. However, he has accepted your repentance and forgave you. So now have relation with them and seek that which Allah has decreed for you. Meaning the enjoyment that Allah has permissible for you, then seek it without guilt. And eat and drink, meaning in the night, until the white thread of dawn becomes distinct to you from the black thread of the night. Meaning until the time that the fast begins, but then complete the fast until the sunset. And do not have relation with them as long as you are staying for worship in the masjid. Meaning during itikaf, this is not allowed. These are the limits set by Allah. So do not approach them, because if you approach them, then you will fall into them. You will violate them. Thus Allah makes it clear His ordinance to the people that they become righteous. They are safe from bad outcome in this life and the next. So try to understand what Allah is saying. These so uhilla is from ha lam lam halal, in which is lawful from the word hil or hul, which means to untie something that was closed or to solve a problem. When something is halal, the restriction is removed, when is allowed to do. Lakum laylata siyam, for you the night. Siyam, the fasting. Laylata, the night preceding the day. Before fasting in Islam, the day changes after Maghrib. So the night comes before the day. Generally means the night of the Ramadan or night before a person fast. Ar-rafasu ra-fa-tha. Rafas literally means to be unclothed or naked. Husband and wife are garment for each other. Rafas refers to private relationship between a husband and wife, their private matter, sexual conduct. Rafas also implies speech, sexual intercourse. Not permissible during Hajj also. Nisa'ikum, your wives. This was not permissible for the Muslims before. Initially, Muslim had option to give fidya instead of fasting, but it was later abrogated. Also, when a person open his fast and pray the Isha Salah, or he slept before praying Isha, after praying Isha or waking up, he would not be allowed to eat or drink or have sexual relationship before the Hukum came with his wife. The fast would begin again at the night. They couldn't eat or drink, have relation with one's wife. This was very difficult for the Muslims. Now, it makes sense why they were allowed to give fidya instead of fasting. Once a companion by the name of Qais bin Sirma, an Ansari man who was fasting one day and working in his land, he was a farmer. When it was time to break the fast, he went home and asked his wife for food. She said no, she would try to get some food. She left and he fell asleep. Then she came back. She said, woe unto you, did you sleep in the middle of next day? He kept the fast the next day without iftar or suhoor. He fell unconscious next day, and it was mentioned to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and his permission was then revealed. And then also Umar ibn Khattab said that he intended to have relation with his wife, but when he came home, she had fallen asleep. So he mentioned to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this allowance was revealed. Hunna, feminine of hum. Then hunna applies to women only, where hum applies to all men or mix of men and women. Libasun lam basim labasa yalbisu. Here clothing, garment, dress. And that this is the reason for the permission of rafas during the night of fasting. Husband and wife are very close to one another. Not possible for them to not enjoy one another for 30 days, 30 nights. So they are called clothing for several reasons. First and foremost, clothing is comfort and tranquility, sakina, sukoon. And second, it covers your aura. Spouse covers and protects the aura of one another. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told young people to get married, those who were able to, because it's the best for lowering the gaze and protection of the private parts. Third, they are very close to one another. Clothing is very close to our body. Fourth, clothing is an adornment, beautification, just as spouse are a means of beautify one another. They complement each other. We should only be praise our spouse, beautifying him, the way we talk to him and about him. Fifth, means of covering physical deficiency in a person. A wish, like, you know, husband and wife, vice versa. covers the faults of their spouse. It's not like, you know, you're talking about your spouse in front of others and, you know, not that. We should hide it. We should be a source of bringing more respect to our spouse. If somebody respects your spouse, they will respect you. How would we like someone to belittle our clothes? Clothing is a need of human being. All other animals do not need clothes. Human can't survive without clothes in the heat, cold. Likewise, human beings can't survive without a spouse. Marriage is a part of perfecting one's iman, faith, of completion one's iman. People think that without marriage they can survive. There are so many pits you will fall into it. Marriage makes one's iman complete and your life complete, satisfied, and sexual relationship in a halal way. That is the only way. There's nothing like a out of wedlock. We should avoid those. And when we buy expensive clothes, we look at the care, instruction to preserve and protect the garment so it can continue to beautify us. Likewise, we need to nurture our relationship so that we can beautify by our spouse. We must fulfill their needs. We should not speak ill of our husband or it will affect our image as well. We should not talk to our children about flaws in our spouse, as the children will lose respect of our spouse and of us. We are being unthankful to Allah if we talk bad about our husband. Takhtanuna khawanun. Qiyana means to be treacherous or to betray. So someone ikhtana, to be very deceitful or treacherous, to do a lot of qiyana. For example, if someone entrusts you with something and you do not take care of it properly, don't return it. Also with regard to a duty that is entrusted, for example, not reading our lesson 7 times, one only or two individual did qiyana by drinking during the night or having relationship during the night when it was forbidden because they did it secretly. So iqtiyan is also when we reduce the issue and says that it's not a big deal. They reduce the importance of particular matter. This leads one to doing wrong. They did qiyana by violating the restrictions imposed on them at the night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows if we have done qiyana. He knows what we do in secret. They betrayed themselves. When a person pretends to be good, show righteousness and piety, and fool people by his show, in reality is completely different. He is actually deceiving and hurting himself. He thinks he is deceiving others, but he is deceiving himself. Allah is watching. Fataba, he has turned to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has abrogated the difficult command of not being able to have relation, eating, drinking after Isha and sleep. So wa'afa ayn fa'wa, he has forgiven for you. Qiyana, only a few sahaba did it. It was very difficult command. Fal'ana, combination of al plus aun, which is time between past and future, which is present. Bashiruhunna bashinra. Bashar is a human being, as his skin is unique and different from other creatures. Bashara tun is used for human skin. Bushra is a good news because it felt on the skin. Goosebumps, bashara, yubashiru is the touching of the skin between two people. It is figurative for sexual intercourse. Fabtahu baghain, yeah, you should see. Kataba, he has written, means what he has ordained for you. This part of ayah teaches two main points. First, having intimate relation between husband and wife is an act of ibadah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded the believers. This is a command of permissibility. Not that you have to be, but it's halal for you. And once get reward. When companions learn that this is an act of ibadah, they were amazed. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them, if a person does this through the haram way, won't be sinful. So he does it in a halal way. So he should get reward. Once get reward because it's done through halal way. One should think of the reward when doing with their spouse is an act of obedience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some people, women or men, they neglect this. This is part of our life. Likewise, if we eat that which is tayyib and say bismillah, we get reward. The same thing with the halal relationship. Seek what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained or written for you. He has ordained for you means children, enjoyment and pleasure. The objective of this act is not just pleasure, but it is also to have family. not like, you know, using contraceptive or using anything to not have children. That's not it. Yeah, you should have children. More children is good. And Allah is Razzaq. Allah will give you. So the next ayah talks about wala ta'kulu, and do not eat amwalakum, your properties. Amwal is from mal. Bainakum, among yourselves, bil batil, wrongfully. Watudulu, and present biha with it ila to al-hukami, authority. Litakulu, so that you may eat fariqan, a portion, min from amwali, wealth, annasi, people, bil ismi, sinfully. Wa antum, while you ta'alamun, you know. And do not consume one another's wealth unjustly, or send it in bribery to the rulers in order they might aid you to consume a portion of the wealth of the people in sin. Well, you know it unlawful. So here the few more hukum we will see. So first we'll finish this ayah, and if we have time then we'll look into the other ayahs. So do not consume one another's wealth unjustly. How is that? Through theft or deception, cheating, robbery, fraud. So do not do that. Nor should you send it in bribery to the rulers in order that they might aid you to consume a portion of the wealth of the people in a sin. Well, you know. Meaning, well, you know that it is unlawful for you to do that. So here we learn, there are few more hukum here. Like, vakulu. Let's complete the word meaning and then we'll go detail into it. We were doing the word meaning of al-khaytu, khaya, pa, used for a thread or a string. Al-abiyadu, the white. Here it means the white thread of the morning. Al-aswad is seen, wow, dal. Sud is used for black. Aswad is very black. Eat and drink until the white thread becomes distinct from the black thread. So the white string refers to the crack of dawn, as the light is a fine line across the horizon. The qayd al-aswad is the black thread of the night. So we can eat and drink until the fajr, time of the dawn. So Ali ibn Hatim said he took two strings, one black and one white, and kept them under his pillow, looking at them throughout the night. He couldn't make any sense of them. So he went to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the morning, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that your pillow must be very wide if the white and black thread are under it. It was being humorous, you know. So he said it refers to the blackness of the night and the whiteness of the day. We should look at the sky in addition to the clock. We can see that the eating suhoor is encouraged. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said eat the suhoor and it's a blessing in it. So atimu ta mim. Tamam is to complete something. So here it says to complete the fast completely until the night. Al-layla refers to the meaning, to the beginning of the night, i.e. sunset. The meaning is to determine from hadith in Bukhari, when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when the night approach from this direction, the east, and the day departs from this direction, the west, then sunsets. So then the fasting person break his fast. One doesn't have to wait for the redness of the sky to disappear. And then we learn akifuna ain kafa, one doing itikaf, plural of akif. Akifa literally means to be in a state of isolation or to devote oneself complete to something, to stay somewhere and do something uninterruptedly. Ukuf means literally to cling to something. So the technical meaning of itikaf is staying in the masjid for the purpose of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the last 10 nights of the Ramadan, itikaf can't be done in home. It can only be done in masjid. The objective of itikaf is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not permissible to have relation with one's spouse. So do not have sexual relationship with your wife while you are doing itikaf in the masjid. Hudud is from hadal dal. Had literally means limit. Hudud are the boundaries of or the borders that have been set or fixed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are two types of hudud. The one, those hudud that prevents those outside from going inside. These are the prohibition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. Muharramat. We are not allowed to trespass. The word takarabu is used with regard to prohibition. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not approach them. Second thing, hudud, that those prevent those who are inside from leaving. These are the commands, that is wajibat. We cannot leave them. We have to observe them. The word tata duha is used. And we are not allowed to violate this. Takrabuha kafra ba. Qurb is to be near. Takrabu is to approach. Here the objective of fasting is to have taqwa. If a woman wants to do itikaf in masjid, she must get permission from her mahram. The sunnah is 10 days for itikaf in the masjid in the Ramadan time. So the following ayah talks about amwalukum bainakum bil batili. The verse talks about the prohibition at all times and all places, not just in Ramadan. Takulu hamza kaf lam. Akala literally means to eat. Here it means to earn, acquire, consume. Usually a major portion of one's wealth goes towards food. Amwalukum bainakum between you bil batili, with falsehood. Vatudlu, and you all offer present biha with it. Ila hukami, those who have authority, just litakulu, so that you all eat farikana, portion. Amwalukum refers to all Muslims, anything a person can legally benefit from, not just money. Bainakum, among yourself. Bil batili, batolam, batil is anything that is false, baseless, wrong. It is the opposite of haq. Which should not earn wealth using unlawful means, riba, lottery, stealing, selling haram things, fraud, zina, using orphans' money, bribery. If one accepts or gives bribe, this is haram. Every way of acquiring wealth that is in haram manner is batil. This deprives another of his right. We should care about the rights and the property of others. We should respect the wealth of another. We would respect of our own belongings. Vatudlu. Dal lambo. Dalva is a water bucket. Idla is to drop down water. Water bucket into well to get water. Because you yourself can't get the water out without your hand. Al hukam is from ha kaf mim. Plural of hakim. Or hakim, a judge. Do not offer it. Do not deliver it. Cast it down to the judges, or do not do bribery. Litakulu, this is connected to tudulu. Don't send your wealth in bribery to the rulers, or so that you get a hold of the wealth of the people. So offering bribe to judge so that he makes a verdict in his favor, giving him a portion of wealth through sin. So that is not, bil ispi is deliberate sin. Sin, jafa, is a mistake done unintentionally. Don't deprive other people of their wealth while you know it's unlawful. It is morally wrong. Why is this ayah mentioned right here after the ayah on fasting? Fasting of 1 month is a training to stay away from the wrong for the rest of the year. Okay, we'll keep it till here. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka natublaik. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Jazakallah khairan kaseera.